You're listening to News and Views on the Duke Radio. My name is Artem Medvedev. This is a show for a week of June 20th. First of all, I want to start with the convention. As you know, there was the federal NDP convention in Vancouver this past weekend, and now everyone is talking about the changes that were made to the preamble of the NDP and decisions to merge with the Liberal Party. Well, as one of the people that was at the convention, I would like to stress that no changes were made to the preamble and to the principles of the NDP, and no decisions were made to merge with any other political party. What the NDP did during the convention was celebrate the 50th birthday of the party and reaffirm commitment to our principles and solutions that were stated in our party platform during the 2011 election, and we wanted to reaffirm that we have the same priorities today as when we were campaigning, and these priorities are jobs, healthcare, education, pensions, and protection of the environment, among many others. At the same time, the Conservatives are visibly stepping away from their electoral promises. As you know, before they had said that they will probably not be able to meet their deficit-cutting targets, as was stated during the election. Now their Senate reform is visibly stalling because of the opposition in their own party, and now we're seeing that instead of the creation of jobs that was so promised and there was so much talk about the wonderful Conservative plans to create jobs and cut down on unemployment, well, now we're seeing instead radical cuts to the public service. Thousands of people will be losing their jobs in the public service as we go further in this Conservative majority government. What is interesting is that among those being dismissed from public service, many are actually accountants and financial and economic controllers and specialists. So apparently, the Harper government doesn't need any data in order to base their important decisions on. Except for ideological reasons, apparently there are no other reasons by which this government will be acting in the future. Hence, there is not anyone to keep them accountable even within their own government. They need no substantiation for any important decisions and steps that they will be taking that will be affecting the lives of thousands of Canadians for years and years to come. Another promise that the Conservatives had made during the election campaign that is being broken right now is the respect for workers and being there for every Canadian, no matter how they voted. The legislation that is in front of the House of Commons right now in regards to the Canada Post strike, which I cannot call any other way but shut up and get back to work legislation, is an actual attack on Canada's workers, Canada's unions, and human rights and dignities in our country. What the Conservatives are doing is giving the Canada Postal workers an even worse deal than Canada Post Corporation was giving them. Therefore, there is a clear message: do not get involved in the labor movement, do not ask for a raise, do not ask for safer and better working conditions, because we will come in and, as our conservative ideology drives us and not the numbers, we will just impose an even worse situation on you and your family. And therefore, just do not get involved, shut up and get back to work right now, otherwise things will only be worse. And attacks on labor unions, attacks on workers, is certainly not something that was part of the Conservative platform this election, but at least we're seeing their real commitments right now, not a few years down the road. And hopefully, this approach will not resonate too badly with the Canadian population, and that many people will stand up and make their opposition heard to this approach to dealing with labor disputes and unfair wages and unpleasant, unsafe, unreasonable working conditions in 21st century Canada. We will probably hear that this legislation is passed very soon, probably during this week, but still this is a very important sign of that the Conservatives are actually starting to lose their nerve and starting to unravel their real radical neoconservative ideology that they had promised they were stepping away from because they were becoming apparently a mainstream party. At the same time as Harper conservatives started attacking the unions and the workers, news came out about a study done on 2009-2010 data on the uses of corporate jets by the CEOs of the largest Canadian corporations. And 2010 was called by many the ending of the most acute stage of the world financial crisis, but 2009 certainly was deep in the middle of this crisis. And this study has revealed through several access to information requests made by CBC and others that at least 30% of all flights on those corporate jets were for pleasure, not for business, with such destinations as resorts in the Caribbean and Mexico, far-off Pacific islands, you know, just to go and see Disneyland and places like that. Sometimes the CEOs would take their families with them on those trips, of course, and therefore we can see that no matter how huge the bonuses would be for the CEOs during a time of deep economic recession and the time when workers are asked to go and work for even lower wages in even worse conditions, no matter how much money the conservatives might be putting in the pockets of the corporate CEOs, we are not going to see any decrease in the level of arrogance, hypocrisy, and waste from the part of those same richest corporations and individuals in the corporate scene of Canada. This is, of course, very encouraging news for anyone that is planning to be a CEO in the nearest future. Not very good news for Canada's population in general. Not very good news for Canada's economy, because the pocket stuffing of CEOs is apparently continuing at the expense of the regular employees. And we're still seeing only higher and higher numbers of waste in a response from the largest corporations. I wanted to end this week's show on a personal note. 70 years ago, my homeland, Russia, was invaded by the Nazis. And as a son and grandson of a historian and a person born in Volgograd, the site of a turning point battle in the war, I just wanted to say that my family and I remember the up to 40 million people that were killed in that war as part of the Second World War. And I always want to think, never again, and hopefully never again, such atrocities will be repeated. But while there is still aggression, and while there is still using force as the only and major tool of solving international disputes, I fear that we're always on the brink of repeating the same mistakes and facing the same memories 70 years down the road. And this is it for this week. Actually, when I was in Vancouver at the NDP convention, I met several of our listeners living all over Canada, and it seems that we in part used this convention to meet up, and I'd like to thank everyone for listening. You can find me on Twitter, you can find me on Facebook, on my blog and YouTube. My name is Artem Medvedev. You're listening to News and Views on the Duke Radio. Have a good day.